Welcome, my dear listener, are all, how are you the friends? That what I will tell you about today. Class 6, lesson number 8. The name of lesson, Goodbye to the Moon. Writer by Monica Hughes. So I started this lesson. I sat in the dark view room of the space station. I looked like that the earth. It was somewhat familiar to me. There was a small photograph of the blue planet in our drawing room. I Kepler Masterman was born on the moon 15 years back. My father had been dead 5 years ago. He has told me stories about the earth that excitingly unknown place. My father is the governor of the moon. He was going on an expedition to the earth, and here was I accompanying him on my first ever journey to the earth. I looked down at earth. It seemed so close to me that I felt I could touch it. You have to wait for another 15 minutes before our journey started. Feeling restless, I left the viewing room and glided down long passage to the center of the space station. I could see my father there, surrounded by reporters. I came back to the view room, which was empty. I looked out into space. My moon, my home, appeared very small now. At home, the kids would be getting ready for the party. There's always been a party at sunrise. The sun rose only 12 or 13 times a year, so it was something special for us. The sunlight crept slowly across the surface of the moon until finally night was gone. Suddenly the door opened behind me. I could hear excited voices. The ferry from Earth must have around it carried passengers from the Earth ready to go for the moon safari. People eager to look around the moon. And here we are going to the Earth instant. I slipped out of the room, the central lobby. Father was standing there. There were the last minute goodbyes. Good luck, Governor, someone called out. See you in 6 months at the latest, replied my father, cheerful. I walked with him to the Earth ferry. It was magnificent. It was 3 times as big as our moon ferries. Is everything on Earth as wonderful as this? I huge pride to father. Pretty much so. Is different from home, father replied. The ferry moved slowly out of the east dock. It entered the Earth's gravity. I found my eyes were closing. It seemed only by few minutes before father's voice woke me up. Kepler, you mustn't miss this sight. You have just entered into the Earth's orbit. Look, I looked light out eagerly. I recognized the narrow stretch of Central America than the majestic Atlantic beneath us. The planet's all water. I gasped, 7/10 of it are father agree. I while that was 7/10 water. On moon, water was harder to get than oxygen. We have to pay for every ounce of it. Washing was a luxury and drink a special delight. I had gone up thinking water was the most precious thing in the universe. Now I could see that the earth was covered with it. You orbited across North Africa and Arabia. I could see the blueness of the Indian Ocean, then the Pacific. Are you feeling unwell? Father asks, don't worry, it will get better. It's just the wind difference. I realized I weighed 6 times my normal weights. After a while, I lifted my head. Passengers were busy collecting belongings you had landed. I struggled with my own safety trust. Father leaned over to help me. Someone called out to my father, Governor, the press and TV are waiting for you. Oh, sure, I will come right away. I watched him leave down the aisle. Immediately, I swearing my legs down to the floor. I realized standing was tough and walking was very difficult. I practiced one foot and then the other up and down the aisle, holding on to the seat backs for supports. I put on my jacket and walked with difficulty to the exit point. I saw a crowd of reporters and cameramen surrounding my father. It was really a new world. There was a storm of voices. How loudly the people of the earth talked. Governor, would you say the difference between earth and moon people can never be solved? I am convinced that you the clear understanding of our problems. The difference can be settled in a friendly manner. Governor, how long do you think you will stay on earth? I guess that it may take as long as 6 months to your to settle our difference. One last question, Governor. Now you are back on earth again. Will you tell our listeners which is really home to you, earth or moon? That's a difficult question to answer. All my cultural twists are with earth, but I must say that it is the moon where my present and future lie. My son was born there. My wife was buried there. My work is there. It is good to be back on earth, but moon is home. Father saw me standing among the reporters. He gave me his arm. We walked together on the landing pad. The sun was gently warm. I looked up. It was strange being outside without a space suit. Earth will certainly be fun. I lay back and thought of the pyramids and the Taj Mahal and the mysterious jungle buildings of the Incas. Would 6 months be time enough to see it all. So friends, where today's chapters, like to complete, like it and enjoy. Those who have not yet subscribed to my channel, they must be subscribed to such adaptation. Thanks a lot to those who subscribe to my channel.